Hello, can you hear me? Good morning to all. Can you hear me? Yes, okay. Okay, Ashwin. Okay, thank you. So tell others to join first, okay? Only 40 are here. Please tell others to join fast. And be ready with your notebooks also. Always you should be ready with the notebooks before starting the class. Hello, so I'll start now. Do you remember where we stopped last class? Do you remember where we stopped last class? Anyone? Nobody knows. There are around 50 students here and nobody is responding. So I myself, no, that was over, Ashwin. Whole 10 was over and we started the next section. Are you not writing down the headings, main headings? See. Those 10 rules were over, and I started with personal passive voice. Isn't it? Do you remember this? And numerical adjectives. I said there are eight kinds of adjectives, out of which you have to study only one adjective, that is adjective of number. Do you remember all that? There are a total of eight adjectives. You don't need to study all the eight adjectives, but only one is mentioned in your syllabus, and that is adjective of number. And then we discussed what are the different kinds of adjectives of adjective of number. Do you remember that? Hello? If you had written it down, then you would have told the points. At the end, I will ask you to submit your notes. Sometimes I will ask you to submit immediately after the class. And if there's nothing in your notebook, it carries marks also for what you are writing down, the lecture notes. Is it clear? Is it clear to you? Okay, Anurag. Okay. Okay, Ashwin. So, I'll just go through what I had said in the last class. If I'm going to repeat again and again, then it is time consuming. So, anyway, I'll go through the last class questions once again. First was personal passive voice, that is Passive voice means the object of the active sentence becomes the subject of the passive sentence. So here, the first sentence, they build houses. So they is the subject and houses is the object. So this will become the subject in the passive sentence. In passive sentence, houses, which is the object, will become the subject. So it becomes the houses are built. And usually the by agent is left out in passive sentences. Even if you write it is not wrong, it is okay. But usually it is implied. So the by agent is left out in passive sentences. Okay, that is about personal passive voice. Just giving you an overall idea since it is mentioned in the syllabus. Then next is the numerical adjectives or adjective of number. This is one of the adjectives among the 8 adjectives. So adjectives are words which are used with a noun to describe or point to a person, place, animal or thing. So adjectives, they are used with a noun. Now the kinds of adjectives include adjective of quantity, quality, etc. Those words we use. She is beautiful. So we are using it with a person to point out to that person. And so those words which qualify a person, they are called adjectives of quality. Then quantity shows number, like few, many, etc. Then adjectives of number, again, it shows cardinal and ordinal numbers. I think I told you this. Adjectives, numerical adjectives, it defines both cardinal. Cardinal numbers are 1, 2, 3, etc. The numbers, the counting numbers are called cardinal numbers. And ordinal numbers are those that shows the order, like first, second, who comes first or which place is first, etc. The order in which we are arranging things. And that is called ordinal numbers. Cardinal numbers shows the include counting numbers such as 1, 2, 3, etc. Ordinal numbers shows the order in which a particular thing can be arranged, like first, second, third, etc. And these are the two kinds of numbers that come under numerical adjective. Okay, I forgot to share my screen. Thanks for the information. Can you see the screen now? Okay, very good. Okay, thank you. So, I think you might have seen all these pages last class. Personal passive voice, then numerical adjectives. I said there are 8 kinds of adjectives, out of which you have to study this one number, an adjective of number, that is kinds of numerical adjectives. There is a definite numerical adjective, indefinite numerical adjective or adjective of quantity, and distributive numerical adjective. These are the 3 kinds of adjectives. I think I covered it in detail with examples in the last class. Next, we said what are embedded sentences. Embedded sentences are if we are able to separate a phrase or a clause, the main clause from a big sentence, and if it forms a meaningful sentence, then that sentence is called embedded sentence. For example, the angry bear howled ominously. I'm going to separate the subject from this. The subject is the angry bear and the verb howled. So I can make a new sentence. The angry is not there because it qualifies the noun bear. So the bear is the subject here. And how old is the verb? If I'm going to separate the subject and the verb, and if it becomes a perfect sentence, then that sentence is called an embedded sentence. So a sentence will be made, a sentence that is made up of a subject and a verb is the embedded sentence. So the bear howled. I can separate that sentence from this big sentence. Then the reported or indirect speech. I think we have to start with reported or indirect speech today. Okay. So take your notebook and write this heading, reported or speech or indirect speech. Are you ready with your notebooks? So whenever I begin a class, be ready with your notebook. Write down the main headings, and as possible, if it's possible for you to write down, note down what is being said in the class. Okay, even examples can be noted down. Is it clear to you? Hello. Okay, so whenever you note down something, write the date, today's date by the side, and note down the lecture notes. Okay, please put the date for each class. When you begin writing lecture notes, please put the date. Did all of you hear this? And even when I check in the end, most of them may not put dates. Make it a habit of writing dates before start writing down the lecture notes. Okay. Put today's date and write down these. That is reported speech or indirect speech. Reported, R-E-P-O-R-T-E-D, reported speech or indirect speech. So reported speech or indirect speech, it is used to communicate what someone else said. Someone else had said something and I am repeating the same what they have said. Like either they have said or about what they think or what they believe, but I'm not using the exact words what they had said. So it usually talks about something that had occurred past. Like they had said that, and that is the keyword, that is the word which is used to introduce a reported speech. Remember this. That is the word which is used to introduce the reported speech, that. So whenever we speak about what someone else had said, we use this word, that, she said that, or they said that. So that is the word, that is the important word that comes in reported speech and will be introduced in reported speech. So reporting verbs like say, tell, ask are also used. They are saying, etc. Or they asked whether you can join the meet. So ask, tell, say, etc. can be used when we make a sentence or translate a sentence to reported speech. So another example of reported speech. Just write this question in your notebook. He said, I will type and you can write it down, okay? Just write down this question. He said, comma, I do not know where to go. He said, I do not know where to go. So this is direct speech. Okay, this is direct speech. He said, I do not know where to go. So now you have to write it in indirect speech. Can you write in your notebook what the indirect speech is? I do not know where to go. Can you write it down? Can you say what the indirect speech is? Anyone? You may type in the chat box. What is the indirect speech for this particular sentence? So you're going to translate into a form what he had said. and making it your own sentence, saying it yourself. How will you translate it? He said, whatever he said is put in quotes. So that is the same sentence which he had said, but we are going to convert it into indirect speech. So when we speak of indirect speech, we must say what he had said in the course, like how we are informing. He said that, let me check. Okay, Niharika, he said that he do not know where he had gone. So he said that do will become past tense. Okay, did. Do will become did. He did not know. Okay, the do will become did. He said that he did not know where to go. Okay, the change is that the present will become past. The present tense is do and the past tense is did. So just convert it to convert the sentence from present to past and add that word, another word that to it. As I said earlier, that is used to convert. So the sentence goes like this. In indirect speech, he said that he do will become did. He did not know where to go. Okay. This is only change, that is the present will become past. So I said in this note here, I said that it usually talks about past. So we have to convert the present form of the sentence into a past form. That's all. Is it clear? Is it clear to you? Okay, these are the changes that you should make. Convert the present to past and use the word that. Is it clear? Then, likewise, there are many sentences. Okay, you can refer to these sentences and work out some of these sentences. Now, let us go to the next part, active voice. What is active voice and what is passive voice? So, when the subject of a sentence performs the verb's action, then the sentence is in active voice. Subject. This is so. Let us look at the sentence. The cashier counted the money. So here the subject is the cashier. And he is doing the work. He is doing this work. So subject of the sentence is performing the verb's action. So then we say that the sentence is in active voice. The subject is doing the verb's action. The verb is counted. You know, action words are verbs. Here the verb, the action word is counted. So this is done by the subject, that is the cashier. So when the subject is doing the action indicated by the verb, then that particular sentence is in active voice. So the next example also, the dog chased the squirrel. So here the subject is the dog and dog is performing this action, chased. The dog is chasing the squirrel. So when the subject is doing action on the verb, then we call it as active voice. Then that sentence is in active voice. Is it clear? Is it clear? When the subject is doing the action on the verb, then we say that sentence is in active voice. Is it clear? Okay. So now let's see what passive voice is. So a sentence is in passive voice when the subject is acted on by the verb. The subject is acted on by the verb. That is, the verb will be acting on the subject. Let us see this example. The monkey. So this first sentence that is in active voice is the cashier counted the money. So you write down that sentence. Write the heading active to passive voice. Write the heading. Active to passive voice. In your notebook, you write the heading active to passive voice and write down the first question. That is, the cashier counted the money. Cashier counted the money. Now this is in active voice. Now write down its passive voice. Write down its passive voice. What is the passive voice? How can you convert it into passive voice? The subject is in passive voice. Subject is in passive voice when it is acted on by the verb. Okay, counted by whose? This word is counted by, and if this word is acted, the by word indicates that whom it is done to. It is done to the cashier. So the counted by the cashier. So we have to just change the order. The money was counted by the cashier. By word indicates whom this action has to be assigned to. Counted by the cashier. Chased by whom? There is a question like counted by whom or chased by whom. Okay, that will follow this verb in passive voice. So the money was counted by the cashier. This word, the cashier counted the money, in active voice, you can change it to passive voice as, how will you write this? The money was counted by cashier. And now this is in passive voice. Is it clear? So write the next sentence. The dog chased the squirrel. Second sentence. The dog chased the squirrel. Dog chased the squirrel. This is active voice. Now write down its passive voice. Write down its passive voice. How will you write down its passive voice? Those who know can type in the chat box. What I had written is the active voice. Now you may convert it into passive voice. Just change the order. How will you convert it into passive voice? Okay, the squirrel was chased by the dog. Yes, that's all. The squirrel, Neheriga, Nainiga. Yes, it is correct. Now, when you start a sentence, just start with T capital, okay? Maybe you're because typing, you're not looking at it. When you write it down, just start with capital, okay? The squirrel was chased by the dog. Quite the answer. Chased by the dog, and that is passive voice. So likewise, sentences will be given, you have to convert from active voice to passive voice. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear to you? There might be a lot of rules. There can be a lot of ways in which reported speech can be done. The reported speech itself are of five or six varieties, but we are not going into deep about reported speech or active voice and passive voice. There are rules in grammar for converting active to passive voice, but just for you to understand what it is, I'm just going through because you have to follow these when you write your reports and all. That's why we are just going through all these. So that's about the grammar section here. Now let us look at some vocabulary questions. Okay. So next, the next section is about technology-enabled learning, and we will cover those sections in detail in the coming classes. We cannot cover it all together in one class. Okay. This effective email messages, slide preparation, and editing skills using software. So we are just going through a one paragraph definition of all these. Okay, and those who are interested, you may start doing all these now. There are editing softwares available for even for image editing or text editing, etc. You can try out various softwares and get skilled in any one of them, like Photoshop and all. They are editing softwares. Then slide presentation is very important for you. You have to present a slide like PPT, and in the next 2 weeks, within the next 2 weeks. So hope you might have seen what PowerPoint presentation is. Have you done PowerPoint presentation? Do you know what PowerPoint presentation is? Most of you might have gone through all that in school itself. Do you know PowerPoint presentations, you know? Anyone? This is a presentation, isn't it? I've done a PowerPoint presentation to discuss these grammar questions. So you have to select one technical topic. Since you are computer science students, you have to select one technical topic and create a presentation, and you will have to present it, for which marks are to be evaluate. I will evaluate the presentation and put the marks. So you will have to create your own presentation and you have to present it. Dates will be announced later. Anyway, there will be a presentation before the end of the semester. Is it clear? So we are gradually completing all these by the end, okay? Then effective email messages, and when we were writing about discussing about letter writing, we were speaking about how messages can be sent and all, how we can address people. Those things in email writing also, we have certain things to be followed, and that comes under effective email messaging. And editing software, those softwares which you are interested in, you can download and use them. Then we have to cover the search engine. Search engines, you know, can you name one search engine? Can you name any one search engine which most of us use? Name one search engine. Google, very good. Yes, Google is a search engine. Yahoo was there. So these search engines, they collect. We can search for any matter through these search engines. You just type in a word and search for it. You will get the details about it. So the search engines. What are the different search engines? It's a problem. Mostly you people know all these, but just we have to discuss what are. Then certain repositories, data repositories. Then certain forums where you can do certain courses and all. Or you can ask questions to people to get certain answers, like GitHub, Stack Exchange. Then MOOC is a massive open online course. And if you are registering for MOOC, then you will be getting around 50 activity points. Okay, do you know that? If you register for a MOOC course. Yes, Niharika, yes. If you are registering for a MOOC course, MOOC, that is, there are certain courses which KTU has suggested for computer science. If you are joining for MOOC courses or NPTEL courses, you will be getting, if you are writing the exam and if you are qualifying the exam, then you will be getting 50 activity points. You have to get a minimum of 100 activity points, out of which by writing this one exam and passing, you will get 50 activity points. So MOOC courses are there. So what we are just going through, what are those, what are the forums available? Then Swayam, NPTEL, Quora. These are certain course platforms that help us to gain knowledge by studying new things. Then there is plagiarism checking. Plagiarism is another thing that we have to discuss in detail. That is, when we copy somebody else's matter, as such, or if a textbook written by another person, if we are copying it as such, then that will be the plagiarism check will find out whether it is a copy of somebody else's. So the checking for a copy is plagiarism. So there are softwares for checking plagiarism. So these are the general things we should consider. We have to cover in this module, but we will be covering it slowly along with the other modules. Is it clear? Because this PowerPoint presentation, you have to prepare a presentation only, then this will become complete. So I will tell you the date when to prepare the presentation and all. Before that, you have to select the topic and I will give you a date when to submit the topic. And after that, you have to prepare the presentation. And when the topic is approved, you have to prepare the presentation. So that all will be discussed later. Now, anyway, first module will be covered, these important sections in first module will be covered along with the next modules. So, next, I just want you to work out one, fill in the blanks, just for improving your vocabulary. So, I'm posting a question here. Just fill in the blanks. Take your notebook and write the following. Write the answers. So, write it as I'm saying. Take your notebook. Put question number one. Exercise one. Put the heading exercise one. Write question number one and write. Fill in the blanks. With suitable words. From the list below. Did you write this much? Exercise one. Fill in the blanks with suitable words from the list below. And write these words. Dash. Pinch, tag, knob and smattering. Now, write down each question. Did you write this much? Did you write this much in your notebook? Did you write this much in your notebook? So you can write this question. The meat was very good, but the curry was dash spicy. And you have to choose one word from this and write it. Can anyone give the correct answer? Okay, you do one thing. You write down all these questions. First question, the meat was very good, but the curry was dash spicy. Next, it's surprising that only a dash of people are eating vegetarian food tonight. It is surprising that only a dash, you have to fill the words from this list, okay, in this blank, of people are eating vegetarian food tonight. Then third, you may like a dash of butter on the toast. You may like a dash of butter on the toast. You may like a dash of, don't write this big thing, okay? I told you, just write this much and then write these sentences. You may like a dash of butter on the toast. Next sentence, would you like a dash of lime on the fruit? It is a question. Would you like a dash of lime on the fruit? And E, how about a dash of sugar in the juice? Again, a question. How about a dash of sugar in the juice? Did you write the question? Did you write the questions? Hello, are you writing down these questions? First write those words on top and then write down these questions. And then you have to fill in the blanks. You are correcting yourself, so be genuine. And you have to fill in the blanks. If even if it is wrong, it's okay. You can just study what the meaning is. Okay, even if it is wrong, don't care. Only then we will study a new word. Okay. Try to fill out words from those lists given above and complete the sentences. All of you should write down, okay? Did you finish writing? Did you finish writing? Are you still writing? When you finish, just say yes, okay? When you finish writing, just post yes in the chat box. Hello. Okay. Ashwin, did you answer it completely or did you finish writing the sentences only? Okay, then you find out the answers in the next class. Okay, okay. When you find out the answers, study the words. And I think I have a class tomorrow, so I'll be asking you the answers. I'll be calling numbers at random. You will have to say the answer and then also the meaning of that particular word. Okay, is it clear? Do it as a homework. Now you may say your attendance.
One.
Okay.
Two.
Okay.
Three.
Four. Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
12.
12?
13.
Okay.
14.
15.
16.
17.
18.
19.
20? 20 absent?
21.
22.
23.
24.
6. 25.
27?
27
present?
27.
Just type in. Okay, okay. 28? 28?
29.
Number 28 absent. 28 absent.
20%.
29%. 30. 28% or no?
20.
20. Okay, I marked 20. 28. Number 28 absent.
29 31 31 32 33 34 35 36 37 38 39 40 41 42 43 44 45 46 47 48 49 50 51 52 53 54 55 56 57 58 59 60 61
62
63
Okay, so all are present. Okay, thank you. Do that work and come in the next class, okay, tomorrow.